story time thing, kind of, because I have a story that happened not that long ago. It's really funny. I'm kind of stressed, so I didn't have time to make, I hope you like, half of the background. Like I showed you in the video before, this one will actually be my background. But at the same time now, you would just see the door. And me in the corner. Ooh, sorry for the noises outside. It is the road, since I live by the road. Okay. So, also, put a thumbs up if you want to see a house tour one time. It won't be made until some other time, like in September or October, since I won't be here as long now. Now, back to the main story. This is the story time that I almost got killed on the bus. So, this happened a couple of weeks ago, and I was taking the bus from my place to the uni, which is really expensive, which I not usually do. I mostly just go to town and then take the bus, but I was kind of tired that day. I wanted to get to the uni really fast and everything, so I decided that it was a good time to take the bus. I went onto the bus. I'm kind of tired today. I couldn't talk loudly. Yeah, everything like that. So I then decided that it was a good idea to take the bus. This one is like for the longer ride instead of like into town directly to the uni. It was like directly into town, go around, and then get to the uni, instead of like, here is my place, town, uni, but it's like town, around, then uni. So the bus driver was kind of like having a bad day. I thought, it's okay, people can have a bad day, even though they're at work. That's something that just happens. But this was not usually a long day, but yeah. When we came, as I was sitting on the bus from my place to uni, I thought the driver was driving kind of fast a little bit, so I was like, oh, it's probably just me. But when people went off from town, there wasn't a lot of people on the bus, then around two or three other people came on the bus. I was sitting in the behind this, like, I was behind, like in the end of the bus, so I felt this more as the bus stopped and hit the brakes really fast and everything. And when people was driving like around, he was driving really fast, more faster than he did from my place to town. And I was thinking, oh, is it just me thinking this? Because he was hitting the brakes, I was holding in the seat front, and I was almost lifted up like that. And I was having my backpack on me, so I wouldn't like, so I would be a little bit more there. And I was also afraid my backpack would go away, as I said. But yeah, then when people went off, they were saying, you can't drive this fast, you have to calm down. That was okay. Until he started to drive really unsafely. He was driving too fast because we were going by the rail, like where the train goes. And these ones, when the lights start to blink, those are going down. But he couldn't hit the brakes because he had too much, like, of speed. He was driving too fast. So he decided it was better to just drive really fast over. And it was like, for me, I was starting like this. And then I started to have a small panic attack, and I started to text my boyfriend like, this is happening. I'm really afraid right now. And yeah, kind of normal thing, you know. But people went off the bus then too, and they were saying, you have to drive slower. And the last person who went off the bus, so I was the last person on the bus, he pushed the stop button. His arm was hurting because he didn't use it or something, I don't know. But he was grabbing something with his other arm when the bus hit the brake, and he's almost falling in the bus. And then he got annoyed, because that is not supposed to happen. And he said then really nicely to the driver, you can't hit the brakes like that. It's dangerous. He was on his way out of the bus. So then the bus driver started to yell, I don't take this shit, blah, 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 and everything like that. And they started to argue. And he was now turned against to the bus driver, so the faces was like that. He has one foot inside the bus and the other outside the bus. And the bus driver is like, I don't take this. And he started to drive while he had one foot on the bus. So he was he's falling outside of the bus, which is not okay. And now I was having a real kind of like, now I'm gonna die. My parents won't know I'm dead until a couple of hours. Think about that. I'm gonna be one of the statics when young people die in traffic and everything, but it's not my fault and everything like that. And I was so afraid. And instead of going to the uni, he decided, like, oh, I have to go back to town. On this point, though, I was scared. I was having a small panic attack and everything. I thought I was gonna die. And I'm also praying to everything in the universe that I will survive. That nothing's gonna happen. That I'm gonna go to the uni safely. At this point, I couldn't stand up on the bus, so I wouldn't say, like, I'm going to the uni and get yelled at, because that's the mood of the driver. If I had stand up, like, excuse me, I was supposed to go to the uni, he would probably start yelling at me because it's my fault that I'm going there. So he drove back to town. On his way back to town, he's taking a lot of people, he's driving really fast. Not as unsafely as before, but I'm like, I'm not gonna sit on the bus trying to get, like, killed. So, I go off the bus, and also, as I'm on the way off the bus, I hit the other bus. I find another bus, go to the uni, everything is alright. And when I came to the uni, I call my friend and I write an email to the company to get everything checked. This is not okay. Please drive safely in the traffic and hit the like button and also subscribe. I love you guys.